are going to start section 3.1 by talking about addition in Alphabetia. So recall that in chapter 2 we talked about Alphabetia, where we have a system, an enumeration system, where we have the kind of quote digits or numbers of 0, A, B, C, and D. And that's really how we enumerate. So 0, A, B, C, D is how we count. The next one after D, if you recall, we have no more digits, so we trade in our D plus 1 becomes A0. And then we have AA, AB, etc. Let's look at a couple of problems. We're going to first start by setting up an addition table. Now, an addition table is really useful to kind of keep track of all of the bits that we can add up without having to refigure the common additions every single time. So we're going to put all of our digits along the side and along the top, and each entry in our table corresponds to adding. So 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus A is A, and so on down this row column and across this row. Now, if we think about A plus A, we think about our number line in order to do this. A, B, C, D, we know the next one's A0, then AA, etc. A is one bump, so if we start at A and add one bump, we get to B. If we start at A and we add B, that's two bumps, 1, 2, so we go to C, and so forth. Notice we're just going down, we're just really enumerating, right? Because we're really just going, adding one, adding another one, adding another one. So that's A0. And we'll copy this way. A plus B is the same in the other direction. So C, D, A0. And again, we can think about this B plus B. So starting at B, go two bumps. A, B bumps gets us to D. But just look, it's the column continued. B, C, D, A0, AA, A0, AA, and so forth. AB, AB, and AC. Okay, now we're ready to look at some problems. The first one, Joe has BC sheep and Marcy has BD sheep. How many do they have together? BC plus BD is the problem we're being asked to complete. Now remember that these problems are coming from my notes, so make sure to be opening that PDF if you want to see those ahead of time. Now how can we complete this? Well, we could, if we liked, start at BC, wherever that is on the number line, and make enough jumps in order to get to BD, but that's pretty time-consuming. We wouldn't do that to add two-digit numbers in base 10, so why would we do it here? So let's use just our standard algorithm, which applies here as well. So first we're going to start with the things in the units column, C plus D. So I'm going to go to my addition table and go C plus D, that's this entry, or likewise it could be the other AB entry, and we get AB, but that's two digits. We don't write down two digits in base 10, we don't do it here either. We write down the ones place and we carry the other one. Alright, now let's start with the B plus B in the next column, and that gets us D. Now to that we add A, so D plus A is A0, and we just write that. So this is A0B. We don't carry or anything because we're done with our algorithm at that point. All right, let's look at the next example. Now, I'm going to assume at this point that you have the addition table easily accessible, either printed off or on another screen or written down or something, because I'm just going to use that idea, those ideas to perform these additions. I want to encourage you, some of you may have seen the link or have thought about the link between Alphabetia and base 5. I want to really, really encourage you not to be switching back and forth between base 5 or even base 10 and these problems. I want you to work inside of the system, and I'm going to say this a few more times in future sections, but the idea here is that you're trying to gain an appreciation of what a student goes through when they learn to add for the first time. You can't gain that appreciation if you go back to the stuff you already know. You have to live in the land of the unfamiliar in order to truly understand what they go through as well. So let's live in the land of the unfamiliar, Alphabetia. B plus C, according to the table, is A0. So I write down the 0 and carry the A. So B plus C, again, is A0 plus an A, That's not on our table, but we can get the idea, can't we? If we're at A0 and we do one bump, then that's AA. So that answer is AA0. BC plus CD. I encourage you as well to stop the videos at these points and determine the answer yourself and then come back, and that's a good way to test whether you're gaining the concepts or not. C plus D is AB, so I carry the A. B plus C is A0 plus another A is AA. All right, part C of number 2 says, what knowledge of counting, place value, and bases did you use and need to know? Well, I used some knowledge about the standard algorithm. That's important because that's something you would have to teach your students how to do. I used my knowledge of counting on the number line in Alphabetia. I also used my knowledge of what place value means, that this C and D go together, and this B and C go together in terms of what I'm adding. And I also used my addition table. That's my knowledge of bases. And part D says, if you encountered any difficulty, what knowledge or tools got you past this difficulty? And that's just something for you to reflect on. What part of your base 10 knowledge and your knowledge of regular arithmetic and addition did you use to get past these difficulties? And focus on that when you're thinking about how you would teach this, how you would teach addition for the first time to a student. Okay, let's do another problem together, and then I'll just give you the answers for the rest of them for you to check. So maybe you want to start thinking about going beyond the addition tables too as you're thinking about doing this, as maybe using the number line in case you needed it. If I'm at D, A0 is next, AA is next, so I don't have to recreate the entire table in order to come up with what D plus B is. D, and I bump twice because that's A and that's B, so I'm at AA. And if I do D plus C, that would be the next one over. So this is AB plus an A would get me AC. And A plus B is C, so CCA is my answer. Okay, as promised, I expect at this point that you would do the other three problems in number 3 by yourself. Make sure you're focusing on the process that you're getting through, whether it's using the number line or using the addition table. Think about how a student is viewing this. Think about your carrying. What does that mean to carry the A? It means we're carrying the place value in the tens place. Maybe think about base 10 manipulative blocks and how that applies here as well to how a student would solve this. I'm just going to give you the answers. So the first one is CC0 and COD plus CAB is AABA. And D0, D0 plus BABA is AABAA. Hopefully I did all those correctly. Okay, question 4 says this problem has missing digits in this spot here and in this spot here, and we need to find them. Now for starters, I'm just a person who likes that standard algorithm. I like these to be in the normal places. But that doesn't have to be the case. And in fact, we ask young children, even say second graders, to perform this kind of thing. And we don't always expect them to put it in this format. So this is a little bit strange that we do this way. We could ask this in a different way. So for instance, I could just look at the place values. D plus what gives me something that ends in B. I'm going to do the same thing down here. I just like this visual better. So D plus what ends in a B. I'm going to look at my addition table, and I see that D plus C is AB. So this blank must be a C. Then I carry the A. Now I'm going to think, oh wait, let's see. A plus C gets me something. A plus C is D. So now I'm saying D plus what ends in a B. Well, again, we just asked that question. This one's got to be a C. So D plus C gets me another AB, so I carry the A plus B is C, it is indeed. So this is correct. The missing digits are both C's. Okay, so that's it on addition and Alphabetia. In the next videos in this section, we're going to talk about some general addition models and algorithms, and we're also going to talk about addition in other bases.